Hey everyone, excuse me. I want to come back and give you some of the basic key skills that will increase your income. And I have seven here that I wanted to share with you. I'm going to read them off. Now the first one here, number one, is prospecting, which is of course finding and spend time with more and better prospects. And these are all areas that we have to, you know, take action on and improve on to get better. Number two, building rapport and trust. So rapport and trust. Taking the time to understand and empathize with the prospect so that they like, trust, and is willing to discuss their needs and problems with you. So this is, of course, getting into the conversations. Number three is identifying needs. This, of course, you have to start asking questions. That's one thing that Jeffrey Combs put it was that sales is mainly about asking questions, you know, asking questions to get to the person's needs and problems so that you can offer a solution. Number four, presenting, moving from the general to the particular, and show your qualified prospect that your product or service is the best choice for them at the time, with all things considered. Number five, answering objections. Now, let's see, presenting logical and conclusive answers for the natural objections that most prospects have regarding the price and capabilities of your product. In network marketing, there's a third-party approval. Some will say that they don't have the money. Some will say they don't have the time. The opportunity that a lot of network marketing businesses offer are a way out of the lack of money and gaining more time. Third-party approval. There's a fourth one. Third-party approval. It's about your life, your emotions, your headspace, which is, I'm talking about your own, you know, reducing your own personal individual stress if you're not liking where you are currently. And for your own sanity, if you have to get someone else's approval, then the present time would not be a good time to try to step out and, you know, pursue that new venture. So the last one, I think I'm on the last one. Oh, number six is closing the sale and asking for action. Bringing the sales conversation to a satisfactory conclusion with a closed sale and a signed order or contract. So, of course, this is generalizing the sales process out of this, from these notes. But, of course, the formula or process that I'm picturing is using the word form to, you know, as a reminder that the F stands for, you know, asking about their family. O is asking about their occupation. R is asking about recreational things they do outside of whatever way that they make a living, you know, doing things just for fun. Then the M is taking all that you've learned and driving it home with that message. So that is closing the deal, finding out if what you're offering is a good suitable solution for them, product or service, then you introduce them to that. One thing I do want to go back to is presenting. So as it said, was move from the general to the particular and show your qualified prospects that your product or service is the best choice for them at this time, all things considered. So the note that I almost forgot to mention about that is you can leverage the internet. You have videos and there's webinar presentations that you can record and let play for them, so you don't have to continue to repeat to each individual person, each qualified prospect. All right, the last one I have here is number 7, getting resale and referrals. Resale and referrals. And referrals, I believe, will really work if you're asking for customers. So if you're a rep, and some opportunities have products that you can let people sample, and you know they can test it out or taste it, whatever, fit, put it on, whatever, and ask for referrals about that, you know. And of course, going to the business side of it, you find out if the person, now if you come across someone on the phone that they'll say, oh, you called the wrong number, I never signed up for it. They probably did, but they probably forgot, or you can just ask for referrals to see if there's someone else that is looking to double their income or triple their income, live a better quality lifestyle and such things like that. You never know, going through that might turn that person around. The better we get at these sales skills, then the person that are kind of rejecting you, they're rejecting themselves, you know. But as we get better with that, the sales skills, then those people that are seeming to be rejecting their own life or a better opportunity, they might turn around and say, okay, because they have your contact information and they might sign up still. You know, they might actually go on and sign up, give them a website or some resource. So that's what I wanted to share with you. I appreciate you listening and thanks for watching. We'll meet up again in the next video.